Man, I got slow and fat. Meg, Meg! So, over the last couple of weeks, I've been so busy that I seldomly have time to come out and train. About 2 p.m., those squat jumps. About 2 p.m., 36 degrees Celsius, windy, warm. Why the hell am I out here? Well, lately I've been trying to combine rifle training with physical training. And so far it's been pretty good. I find I get a solid workout in. I try and come sort of in my lunch hour, even though I work for myself. Pump some tunes on the bucky, do a couple of sets like that. Which mag did I just fill up? Or put a few in. Usually get my rifle, I run between props, really trying to get that heart rate up, target at 100 meters. I don't run with the mag in, and I'll show you why. Not good. All right, let's go. So while the heart rate's up, just try and get like a double whammy. Really concentrating on the shots. So that's kind of what we've been doing. Hope you guys enjoy it. This, by the way, if you've ever shot a match with me, this is my jam. In fact, my 6-dasher, even though I don't have it already, it's gonna be codenamed Sugar. Because on this jam, we do work. Usually before a stage, I'm standing on a line like this. I'm not worried about shooting. I'm just here to have fun. Let's go burn some. Got one round. Let's go off the tree with one at the end. You guys won't be able to see it. You're gonna have to take my word for it. Maybe you can hear the cling. Gonna run back, grab this mag, go one off the barricade, and then we're done. Sessions like this, I also don't bring a lot of ammo, one box. So far I've shot 10, 20, 30 rounds, not even 30 rounds. Quality over quantity. Out of my, let's say I've shot about 20, there's a few lying here, 27, I've only dropped two. Previous session, did 76 rounds, dropped one. So super focused on the trigger pulls. Again, before every rep, pump the heart rate. Woo! Man, I got slow and fat. Mag, bag. Let me cut the music. So that's kind of how some of my workouts go. Again, I see this as an actual workout, but why not double it with precision rifle training? Now, I get that you guys don't have a range like I do, so I understand that, but if you don't care what other people think of you, you could do this at a normal range and literally just go with some of these. You didn't think you were gonna get an exercise video today, did you? In those houses over there, there are people watching me do this shit all day long. I don't care what other people think about me. One of my good friends always says, what other people think about you is none of your business. Now, as long as you're not an asshole, I think that's kind of a very true statement to live by. Try and be a good person. You're not gonna please everybody. So if someone doesn't like you, then don't try and please them. With my YouTube channel in South Africa, I get some hate, but as that saying goes, haters gonna hate. Anyway, I hope you guys learned something from today. By the way, separate video perhaps, we could do a video on how to get rid of first stage jitters. I've got something that I do at all the shoots, which is quite similar to actually what you saw today. So let me know if you guys want a little minute long video on how I do that. In one of our upcoming videos, we will be going through the final video of the CZ455 rimfire video. Also, a bunch of you asked in my previous shoot better video, what scope cam did I use? I use a camera called the Trigger Cam, South African company. I will probably be start selling them soon, so have a look out on my store. Sorry, I'm really out of breath and out of shape. But these sessions have proven to be valuable to me in the past. This is how I used to train. Maybe not quite as extreme during the heat of the day and then the wind. But like we used to say when we raced bicycles, train like you race. If you come out, you shoot in the wind, you shoot when it's warm. When you get that in match day, it's something that you're used to and you don't all of a sudden struggle with that. Anyway, I also need to make a correction. In one of my previous videos, I said I had multiple national level wins shooting MDG products. Now, as a passionate fan pointed out for us, I don't have multiple wins shooting MDT products on a national level. However, I have been robbed of a few. If you know what's going on, you'll get the pun with that. But I'm not gonna cry over spilled milk. I think I'm confident enough with my abilities that when I do go to a big match that I know that I can hang with the best shooters, especially in this country. Not to take anything away from any of our good shooters, we have really good shooters here, but you Americans, you guys are literally on another world. And we've got a lot of catching up to do here, but we always look forward to shooting with you guys, and I will see some of you at an upcoming shoot later this month. Anyway, I appreciate you watching. If it's your first time watching my channel, all my videos are not like this. Usually we have multiple cameras running, and it's a little bit more educational, and you won't see me running off into the distance, hopefully again in a video. Today I had an interesting experience, nearly rolled my bucky down a massive mountain. It's out of the frame here. I drove up this Jeep track and all of a sudden it got really loose and really steep, and I knew I wasn't gonna make it up this section, so I stopped before I sort of spun myself in. Super loose, rocky, fynbos cliffs both sides basically, and I somehow managed to reverse and do like a J-turn. Very close, but it was successful, and now we have a target that we can engage at beyond a kilometer. So I look forward to sharing some more trigger cam video so you guys can see sort of what it looks like when we shoot out to that distance. Anyway, once again, I'm gonna wrap it up. 30 rounds is gonna be it for today. Again, quality over quantity, and I need a water. And then tonight we're gonna have a Stella. By the way, speaking of Stella, it's a beer, Belgian beer. Coupon code for 10% off any Vortex stuff for until the end of March in South Africa on my store, Impact Pro Shop. Use the coupon code on checkout, 10% off any Vortex stuff. It could be casual wear or whatever the case may be. I'm thinking we should do the Shoot Better series on Friday, so that if you guys learn something on the Friday evening when you're watching this after a hard week, then you can take it out to the range the next weekend and go practice that. So let me know if that format works for you guys. So we'll do other video Monday, Shoot Better video on Friday. Anyway, guys, this video's been a little bit longer than I thought it would be. Just a quick one, 14th of March, NRL National Rifle League match on this range. I'm gonna link that down below too. Everyone, remember to always leave a comment and a thumbs up. Share some of your training tips, how we can all shoot better. If you wanna downvote this video, I appreciate that too, because your downvote still ups the engagement on the video and helps me earn a little bit more money. Maybe we can make it to 1,000 rand a month for making twice a week YouTube videos. Once again, thank you to every single one that's a Patreon. And you guys will have seen this video about a week and a bit before the rest of you. So link to that down below too, so you can help me make more videos. I looked into hiring cameraman. We're gonna start doing that sort of stuff from about April. So I'm super pumped. I'm very humbled by the growth of the channel over the last month. It's been unbelievable, and I'm super pumped for everyone for helping us to achieve that. We're almost at 10,000. I'm pumped beyond belief to get to 10,000. Thank you for watching Impact Shooting and the Shoot Better series. Make sure you're subscribed and the bell is turned on so you don't miss an episode. Bye.